This is National Sleep Awareness Week, and we're taking a closer look at ways to improve our sleep. On average, most healthy adults need 7 to 9 hours of sleep a night. However, tossing and turning and other disruptions can make us feel as if we didn't get any sleep at all. So it may be time for us to change up our routines. Sometimes sleep can be anything but restful, causing many people to wake up with aching backs, stiff necks, and shoulders.
What we can do as physical therapists is teach them better positions so that they minimize all of those dysfunctional patterns and positions that they have.
Karena Wu, founder of Active Care Physical Therapy, knows being aware of how we sleep can improve the way we wake up. For stomach sleepers,
so I'm like really kind of backward bent. And then you have to turn your head to the side to sleep, so that causes this rotation here. And that becomes uncomfortable after some time. So then you have to switch, getting a smaller pillow so that you're not as extended in your low back here. And then trying to keep your neck not as rotated, so you're facing the mattress a little bit more. And you're not twisted as much.
And there are those who sleep on their sides.
If you're too much in the fetal position, so heads down into the chest, knees are all the way up into the chest, that rounds the low back and the neck, so that promotes that forward posturing, which is not great. Really curling under so that the elbows are bent, the wrists are bent. Staggering the legs twists the low back here, and that can cause low back pain here. So the better position would be to actually straighten out the spine, bringing the head back in space so it's more upright. It's a more straight position here, making sure the elbows and wrists stay in neutral, so you keep it flat like that. Putting a pillow in between the knees, keeping the legs stacked, actually keeps your low back here more in a straight and neutral position.
Lastly, back sleepers.
Sleeping with the legs out to the side, or even what's called like the starfish or spread eagle. That's a position that is not great because you keep all your muscles in a shortened position. So from the top, I would want to put this pillow directly under my head and neck, so I'm supporting the natural curve here, and it's not under the shoulder, so that I could wrap my shoulders back here. If you put a pillow under the knees here, that actually puts the low back in more of a relaxed position. So people with low back pain, this is very comfortable for them to sleep in.
And hopefully that will lead to a better night's rest.
Well, clearly I sleep in all the wrong positions.
I do too.
I mean,
like every way she showed, I'm like, oh yeah, I sleep
yeah,
like that.
I'm more of like,
that.
I hunch everything into the fetal position. And
fetal position
holding
sleeper.
All these pillows and...
And I have like blankets that go up to my nose.
I do wake up in the same, I don't move much though. Once I'm asleep,
oh, lucky you.
I'm there, just in that position.
Oh, I wish.